fast.
DJ Finesse here, Video Explosion, here in the Little Home Studio in New Jersey. Today we're going to be reviewing an interview I did with Heavy D.
Welcome to another edition of Video Explosion. I'm DJ Finesse here at Money Earning Mount Vernon. This very special guest, overweight lover, Heavy D. What's up, man?
What's up, yo? How you feeling?
Cool. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, man.
Producer of Video Explosion called me, or maybe paged me in those days, right? Hey, MCA Records called. They want us to interview Heavy D at his house. Haywood and his wife, Asanya, picked me up. And we rolled up to Mount Vernon, New York, up in Westchester County. And I remember his mother answered the door. And we went in there, got to meet some of the family, and started to conduct the interview. So very grateful for that opportunity. Heavy D was real chill. Just, believe it or not, a regular person, you know, friendly, accommodating, cool. You're just sitting down talking to him. And we were just talking about the Blue Funk era.
Blue Funk, the LP is real slamming. What made you want to switch some of your producers from like the last round of like Marley Marl and Teddy Riley?
Marley and Teddy are still two of my favorite producers. But you know, like for longevity and for different sounds and artists of my caliber, not being egotistical or anything like that, just letting it be known that I could do certain things and, you know, have an opportunity to work with new producers, work with Premier, who's somebody who I admire as a producer, and, you know, of course, my cousin Pete. I wanted a different type of sound, and I wanted to take it to a different direction, but at the same time, still maintain what Heavy D and the boys represent.
Heavy D definitely set the table for Blue Funk with a few of his prior projects with Don't Curse, and of course on the B-side, You Can't See What I Can See.
You blind, baby. You blind, baby. You're blind from the facts.
Heavy D took no prisoners on that record either, and that was a, you know, a serious record with hard beat and hard rhymes.
Instead of a victory, he got evicted me. I'm not pressed, I'm on a peaceful journey. Lock like a padlock, gotta make your head bob. Not Fred Flintstone, gotta make your bed rock.
He was letting you know again, I'm here, and I can represent, and I can hang lyrically. So these were, if you think about it, table setters for what was to come with Blue Funk. Heavy D also was on the roll with the Flavor single, which I believe came out in 1993, and there was a video for that single as well.
I got Flavor for days. Check this out.
Once again, it's off. It's where I'm from. There ain't no picket fences. Picket's right in box. So you pick it either. Stick it, trick, or what the fuck.
Banging record. Again, Heavy D did his thing on there, spitting on Roll With The Flavor.
I flew the spot. I'm stupid in my props, and now I am just passing through. Rough, rugged, rigid. The one who's quick to figure. Some kids are big, but the hamster is bigger.
So again, another table setter for what was to come. You know, with the production and lyrics on Blue Funk, it was definitely a new era for Heavy D, a little more on the darker side, but he still never left his brightness as far as his personality and the things he talked about. Right now, though, you know what? Let's head out to Mount Vernon, New York. Check out the Heavy D and the Boys mural. Let's go. Follow me.
Back here, y'all, as promised, Video Explosion at the Heavy D and the Boys mural right behind me. We're here in Mount Vernon, New York, Westchester County, Money Earning Mount Vernon, home of Heavy D and the Boys, Denzel Washington Jr., Al B. Shore, Pete Rock and CL Smooth as well. So we're here giving props and love to Heavy D and the boys. Check out what's going on behind me. We'll also have a special guest with us today. Stay tuned. Back here on Video Explosion, Mount Vernon, New York. Very special guest with us, Andre Trenier, who is the man who designed this mural that you're looking at, this beautiful piece of art. Andre, welcome to the show. Thank you for being here today.
Oh, it's a pleasure, man. Great to meet you.
Great to meet you as well. Hey, tell us about the mural, and when did you actually put the mural up?
It's been quite a few years. I forget exactly how many years, but it was cold like this when I painted it. So I'd come out here and it'd be like frost and snow on the ground, and up here with the ladder, just picking away at it day by day. So it took me about a month. Was blessed to meet Heavy D and interact with him on more than one occasion. But in doing this mural, I got a chance to meet his whole family. His sister has since passed away. It was an honor and a pleasure to be able to pay tribute to Hev and to Trouble T. Roy, who I was surprised that there wasn't any murals or something like that for him since he had passed away so long ago.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the detail or what goes into putting up this mural as far as the colors, your concept, anything you could share with the viewers?
As far as process, this was actually my first really large scale mural. So I kind of had to figure out a lot of things as I was going with this. I always loved the Kente cloth that was in, well, they rock Kente cloth a few times. Mm-hmm. And the blue tone, like I always loved the Blue Funk album. Mm-hmm. And so I took some cues from that. It just came together the way it did. And then Be Inspired was Heavy D's final tweet. So that felt like it was the proper thing to just tie everything together. This is one of my favorite things I painted.
Hey, bankroll and Skeeter, what's happening? What up, y'all? What's going on?
I heard you got a new toothpaste, man.
We are here with the legendary stand-up comedian talent. We appreciate your time, brother. We're here to talk about Heavy D.
And that's legendary.
That's legendary.
I'm just still a coworker. Heavy D, now you're talking iconic. Now you're talking trendsetter. Now you're talking, before the word gatekeeper was fashionable, you're talking all that, you know, but he didn't use his superpowers for evil, nothing but good. Got nothing but love for you, baby.
Speaking of which, what was it like doing that video with you, him, Chris Tucker?
It was amazing. I wasn't supposed to be there.
All the models.
Hell, top models. Tell me about it. Let me tell you something. First of all, I wasn't supposed to be there. But this is how, I just said how generous this man was, right? So he has this video slated, and they're down at the shoot, and they're doing the wardrobe and the sets and stuff. They didn't shoot yet, you know? And Chris Tucker's booked for it. Chris Tucker and I are comrades and know each other from comedy too. But I went to school with Hev. We had classes together. So out of nowhere, my phone rings, and it's Joe Black, and he's like, T, what you doing? I said, I'm chilling at the house, whatever. He's like, yo, hold on, Hev wanna talk to you. He puts Hev on the phone. I said, yo, Troy is my middle name. Yo, Troy, get your ass down here, man. We shooting a video, nothing but blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, what? He said, your boy here. Then he passes the phone to Chris Tucker. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, what? He's like, I said, well, what is it about? You know, because me, I'm just like that. I'm a tourist. We need details. He was like, I don't know. Just get down here. We're going to figure it out. Y'all funny dudes. We're going to figure something out. So we get down there, and literally, he just had a wardrobe truck full of crazy old. He just knew the vibe he wanted, because you could see his lapels and the collars on his shirt and the vibe, how he was dressed. He wanted that funky, you know, Heavy was always dope with that. And he was like, y'all just pick something out, man, and come up with something, whatever. So as I'm looking around the set, I see all these top models. I'm like, damn. I said, you know what? So me and Chris is vibing what we're going to do. you know what? We're looking at the clothes. Oh, they got some old school stuff, the hats and the feather in it. Let's be two pimps. Okay, two pimps. All right. Yeah, and we mad at him, you know, because these are all our chicks. We wondering why our chicks ain't on the stroll out here, and the head of them around got our chicks, right? So I was like, okay, well, we need names. So it's like, I got a lot of money on me, nigga, bankroll. He said, yo, Skeeter. I said, you look like a Skeeter. Bankroll and Skeeter. And the truest, most organic part of the damn video was when the girl walks through and I go, yo, that's that Noxzema chick, because that commercial was ran heavy. And who knew I'm gonna be in the room with this chick, right? So I'm in the room and she walked through her little model strut. And I was like, but I'm still in my voice and character, but I'm real serious. I'm like, that's that Noxzema girl.
I'm gonna get my groove on. What's up?
And like that line, they loved it. So if you notice in the video, they dropped the music just to catch that line. Right. And then the music comes back up. So it ended up being like an accidental iconic moment in the video. But that's how Nothing But Love came about. You know, everything in there, we just improvised. We go, they did the Soul Train line. We was like, all right, we're gonna do the horse and rider shit. I'm on the ground here, and we waving it. High school. If you come to Mount Vernon is a small town, 4 square miles, literally. So Southside's where I grew up at, the projects. Myself, J.B. Smoove, came up in the same projects, right? Northside, you got Albie Shaw, you got Jeff Red, you got Pete Rock, you got Heavy D, Stephanie Mill, all of them on the north side, right? And we, you know, Denzel was on the south side. Shout out to Denzel. You got Thug Point, son. So we met in high school. I want to say maybe 10th grade. I want to say it was 10th grade. So Heaven and I had wood shop together. You know, the vocational class. So he always find it, like we always find it funny to call each other by our school names or names we know in the hood. So, you know, I'm calling him Dwight. He gonna hit me with the Troy all day. And the Heavy D name got the most weight in Mount Vernon. So the first song would be Money Earning Mount Vernon.
Yeah, a lot of people listen to this rap, cause I'm about to throw down and put my town on the map. And see Heavy D, delighted you be learning about the place where I rest.
He wore it on the sleeve, he repping Mount Vernon, and he's letting his peers know, all these other hip hop artists, yeah, I know you Brooklyn, I know you Queens, I know you the Bronx, I know you Long Island, all the shit they repped. But Mount Vernon here, I'm Heavy D and the boy, bomb. So he put the flag, put us on the map. That one got to be in there, number one. Number two, I would put Nothing But Love in there. Because Nothing But Love was, to me, that was Run DMC's Walk This Way.
Ooh, why do you say that?
Because he transcended. He let you know he wasn't just hip-hop no more. When you listen to Nothing But Love, you don't just hear a rapper doing a rap song. That's a fucking song, bro, that broke the barrier. So that got to be in there. Now, the next three, you got to go to the classics. Mr. Big Stuff.
MCs around, who front and front. You go round for round, I go pound for pound. At the end of the party, when you're saying goodnight, don't come to me and say, take it light. I'm your Mr. Big Stuff.
Put him on the map. Overweight Love in the House got to be 4. And I'm torn for number 5 between Peaceful Journey and Don't Curse. And the things in the name is like self-explained. Like Peaceful Journey is a heart for, again, this was an era. If you remember when Hev comes in, this is the beginning of what New Jack is about to be.
T.R., bring it in.
So when Hev kicks into the New Jack segment thing, he set a formula that everybody would follow now, mixing the R&B with the hip hop. He started that. The one thing, if you strike up a Heavy D conversation that stayed constant, was this guy was a dope rapper with good music, and then your parents would be like, hey, he don't curse.
I don't have to swear, curse, or juggle lyrics in the verse to make a party bubble.
So you know what he did? He extended beyond himself and said, I'm gonna make a song, don't curse, and I'm gonna bring on cats that normally would curse, and they're gonna do a verse and don't curse, the Kool G raps.
Yeah, that's what I
think. The Kubas, they slide their curses in there, but they came on here and show you, man, we could rock hip. We could represent hip hop the way you represent hip hop. And that was a game changer. So them are my top joints of Heavy D. Don't get me wrong, it's way more. That's why I say it's tough, but I try to do my best to bring it in. You know what I mean? But yeah, Hev forever, man.
What's up to everybody? I'm back.
Peace. Heavy D, there he is. Mr. Big Stuff. Mr. Big Stuff. This is DJ Finesse. I'm going to sign off for now. See you next time on Video Explosion.